magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
When the mirror tells the wicked queen that she's been outclassed in the beauty department by her stepdaughter, Snow White, those of us who were children in the 1930s weren't a bit surprised. We knew that the queen wasn't going to sit still for that, and we were trapped.
Take her far into the forest.
Yes, Your Majesty.
And there, my faithful huntsman, you will kill her.
Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs premiered here in Hollywood in December 1937, and on its first release, it was seen by more people than saw Star Wars on its first release. Now it's on its sixth re-release, and the first feature-length cartoon ever made has become one of the 10 most popular films of all time. It won for Walt Disney this unique statue, an Oscar with seven dwarf Oscars, spectacular vindication for what Hollywood had called Disney's folly. Hardly anyone believed that moviegoers would sit through an hour and a half cartoon. Production costs escalated from $150,000 to $1.5 million. And in the depth of the Depression, Disney had to show bankers clips of the uncompleted film to keep the money coming in. Almost everyone had underestimated Disney's genius and enthusiasm.
There was a fire under all of us. Every one of us worked Saturdays, Sundays, nights, everything else. We just loved it. Everything was new.
There are many reasons for the world's love affair with this movie, which Disney extracted from a fairy tale by the brothers Grimm.
Dwarfs' names fit their personalities. This pompous-looking individual is Doc.
Just whistle while you work.
The songs in the film had America humming and whistling in the Depression days, and Adriana Caselotti, the voice of Snow White, recalls that at age 18, she could sing like a princess.
I'm wishing for the one I love to find, to find.
Walrath Kimball, one of the Snow White animators, recalls that at the premiere, he was not surprised that the film produced laughter, but that pen and ink drawings could produce tears.
To see those dwarfs come up to this bier and take off their hats and get down on their knees and then back away, everybody in that theater was crying. I heard the sobs. I looked around, and here were Marlene Dietrich, Clark Gable, Lombard, all of them, and they were wiping their eyes.
There's a whole new batch of kids born since the last release of Snow White in 1975. Parents are advised to bring handkerchiefs. Stephen Geer, ABC News, Hollywood.